Donald Trump is testing the limits of the partial gag order that was placed on him a couple weeks ago in the New York fraud trial. Now, what happened a couple weeks ago was that Donald Trump put out a vicious lie saying that one of the court staffers was somehow the girlfriend of Chuck Schumer. And because of this, that court staffer ended up getting a lot of threats from Donald Trump supporters. So the judge did, in fact, put a partial limited gag order in place, telling Donald Trump, you cannot attack any personnel in my court. That was it. Letitia James, Attorney General of New York, was not on that list of people he can't talk about. So this week, Donald Trump gets on Truth Social, reposts an article from right-wing weirdo Laura Loomer that included the home address, what is believed to be the home address of New York Attorney General Letitia James. So effectively, Donald Trump, whether he intended to or not, ended up doxing Letitia James. And it's worth mentioning as well, the Loomer article, she had financial statements from Letitia James, purportedly from Letitia James, that had a home address on there. And it is believed that that is James's home address, and that's how this whole thing started. But Trump didn't just put out the article that has her home address on it that, by the way, easily could have been blacked out by Loomer if she had thought about it or if she wanted to. I don't know if this was an oversight on her part or if it was intentional, but the address was there. She could have blacked it out and she didn't. But anyway, Trump posts the article along with this note. Her fake case against me should be dropped immediately. My financial statements are extremely conservative and her numbers were way off, including the fact she undervalued Mar-a-Lago and Doral by billions of dollars. She also didn't reveal the 100% disclaimer clause at the front of the financial statements and that she sued me under a statute that was never used before. That is 100% not true. Miscarriage of justice and election interference all wrapped up into one. So you post an article that has her home address. You then add to the post that this woman is somehow abusing the justice system to unfairly go after you and interfering in a United States election. Now, the election interference thing is exactly what Donald Trump was telling his supporters shortly before, I mean, literally minutes before they marched to the Capitol and did their little insurrection. So we know how worked up Donald Trump's base gets when he talks about election interference. And here he is, again, maybe intentionally, maybe not intentionally, sharing an article that has Letitia James' home address while making those same lies that he made right before his supporters walked around chanting, "Hang Mike Pence." Again, Letitia James is not mentioned in the gag order. But it's time for that gag order to be expanded. Somebody's going to get hurt. It is not a matter of if, it is a matter of when. This is crossing a line. And the judge has to recognize it. And the judge has to take the, yes, extreme step of preventing Donald Trump from talking about anyone involved in the case in any way. His supporters are already not all there. They just need the tiniest little tap to push them over the edge. And Donald Trump every day is tapping and tapping and tapping and tapping at these people, feeding them lies like this is election interference or a miscarriage of justice or that Letitia James is racist against white people. And now they know where she lives. Something has to be done to stop this before somebody gets hurt. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.